Would you look at that? The citizens of Yulmore engaging in what can only be described as manual labor. Who would have thought it possible? Do you know the most reliable way to deal with those who stubbornly refuse to see reason? You conquer them, crush them under heel. Such was the trusted method of Alec, and one still favored by Garlemald. But conquest is the easy part. The true challenge begins once the dust has settled, quenching the glowing embers of animosity and maintaining a semblance of peace. This requires the conqueror to treat the conquered with dignity and the conquered to let bygones be bygones, a difficult feat to achieve. But you have achieved just that, to my considerable surprise. It's a compliment. Take it. The vibrant energy that fills the air when like-minded souls gather. To think back on that time before time, fair brings a tear to the eye. What? You thought ancient beings like us incapable of crying? Well, rest assured that if your heart can be broken, then so can mine. Back when the world was whole, we had family, friends, loves. Men knew peace and contentment, and with our adamant souls, we could live for an age. There was no conflict born of want or disparity. Our differences paled into insignificance next to all we had in common. Then there was Amaron. Never was a city more magnificent. From the humblest streets to the highest spires, she fairly gleamed. Not that you would remember any of this. Never mind. The point is, the world of old was a far better place than what we have now. I believe you would like it, having witnessed the things you have. Remember, you are of the source. Unlike the half-men here, you stand only to gain. Should you survive the remaining calamities, you will become our equal. A complete existence in a complete world. But such talk is a pleasure for later. Back to work, hero. Ah, there was one thing I had meant to ask. How well do you know the Exile? Has he ever deigned to show you what hides beneath the cowl? What? Never? Even to you? How very interesting. I shall enjoy working out what it means. Until next time.
It's alive. I don't know if you remember, but when we first met in this world, I was all but spent. I never thought to wonder why until now. I think it all just got to be too much. The guilt of causing the flood. Knowing everyone hated me. But the worst thing was the solitude. Time wears you down, Hai. Solitude eats away at you. It was this close to finishing me off. But as bad as it got, and as empty as I felt, I can't even begin to imagine what it must be like for Emmett's son. All of which is a long way of saying, don't make a choice that leaves you alone. Nothing is worth that. Especially not eternity.
Glad tidings, my friend. The ladder lives again.
The three of us have been invited to do the honors. Are you up for it? Of course, if you're worried that the whole thing might come crashing down, we can always find someone else. That's the spirit. Come on, then.
We rode the ladder too, my comrades and I. Once upon a time. Watched the horizon grow, and the town shrink below us. Awed and terrified in equal measure, we ascended without a word, the silence broken only by the rhythm of the gears. No one but me remembers that day. Remembers our journey and our end. Retread the path. Seek, and you may yet find.
you're a sight for sore eyes. I don't know about you, but I bumped into quite a few sin eaters out there. You too, then. It seems the closer we get to Mt.Gulg, the more of them there are. Looks a lot bigger from here, doesn't it? If I were Vorthry, the first thing I'd do is surround myself with as many Sin Eaters as I could lay my hands on. And judging by the number we've already faced, his lordship is of the same mind. This is going to be a tough climb. But first things first. We need to determine if climbing is even an option. The more I look, the less likely it seems. Ishtola is right to be worried. But flying may be our only choice after all.
There you are. Master Alphino was afeard you had met with some misfortune.
Briogia. And you too, Exarch. What brings you here?
I wish to observe the final struggle with my own eyes. I arrived at Bottom Rung too late to accompany you, but I was in time to join Briogia and the others. Come. Let us see how this unfolds.
Seems flying is off the table.
If we have learned that much, then the Machina have served their purpose.
Ah, so that's what they were for. Wasteful, but effective.
It would seem our foe will not be reached by land or air. We must needs withdraw to consider another course. Master Alphino waiteth for us atop Rung. Thither should we make our way.
In short, there's no path, and the sky is thick with Vorthry's winged devils.
We might consider Amuro, but without extensive training, we cannot hope to contend with the Eaters. Yulmor's airship fleet, meanwhile, consists solely of transport vessels ill-suited for battle. And without the expertise of one such as Cid, we are in no position to attempt a refit.
Oh, it's so frustrating! That wretched mountain should jolly well come back down to Earth!
Now, dearest, we mustn't disturb these good people at their work. Ridden the ladder and seen the sights, it's past time we took our leave.
The lady may well have the right of it. Mt.Gulg will not soon come down to Earth, nor can we compel it to do so. But if the mountain will not come to the land, mayhap the land may be made to come to the mountain. In the form of a Talos. A Talos large enough to reach out and take the volcano in its grasp.
Build such a golem would be an onerous undertaking indeed, yet the principle seemeth sound in itself.
Balderdash! No one has ever made one even half that size. Leaving aside the small matter of logistics, which, by the way, would be no small matter, the design would be unimaginably complex. Though, I suppose... Its only function is to cling to the ruddy mountain. Perhaps it needn't be. Solid base, firmly rooted to the ground, sacrifice mobility to simplify the construction, reducing materials required.
Wait, what am I thinking? We would still need a veritable army of people to do the work.
Left to the crew that helped down below, it would take decades, if not a nice round century.
So we need more hands. And what sort of things would these hands be required to do?
Well, let's see. First, we need people to procure the stone for the chassis. The rock found near the mountain would suit our purposes well enough. It would be a simple task to quarry the stuff, but given the stupendous quantity required, we'd need all the help we can get.
We have friends amongst the miners of Armoray. I will go and petition their aid.
While you do that, I'll make for Mordsuk. I'm sure I'll be able to drum up some support.
Then I shall return to Calusia. From fishers to carpenters, Yulmor is home to all manner of talented folk. I dare say their skills will avail us.
Is there anything else you need?
Well, yes, actually. Magic. Lots of this stuff, as much as possible. To awaken a Talos of this size would require an entire congregation of mages.
Many among the Knights Blessed are gifted in the arcane arts. I will recruit them to our cause.
The Fae folk, too, possess surpassing aptitude in magics. Yet they are not wont to cooperate in the endeavors of men. Leastwise, not without making all manner of mischief. That being the case, I would instead call upon the people of the Crystarium, with thy permission, Exarch.
We are at your disposal, as are our Amuro and Chocobos.
I'm sorry. You mean to tell me you can call on not only the people of Yulmor and the Crystarium, but the Knights Blessed and the Maul, and even those miners? But that's just about everyone in Bally Norvrat. Who are you people? And how did you come to have so many friends?
dearest, have you forgotten already? Alfino told us that when we first met.
Actually, that may not have been... No, never mind.
So, as you can see, you will not want for bodies. I trust you will have your design ready in good time for their arrival. Norvrant is counting on you, heir to Daedalus Stoneworks.
We'll be back as soon as we can, and we'll bring the whole world with us.
I take it we will be assisting Master Chai, though I am quite sure he has everything under control.